Good morning, good afternoon, everyone. I'm speaking to you from The Island, our group and regional headquarters in Paris. I am glad to have this opportunity to share an update on Pernod Ricard EMEA LATAM strategy, our key initiatives and business performance, which has been remarkable last year. This update happens at a turning point in our environment, with geopolitical tectonic changes, with the post-COVID evolution of globalization and consumer behavior, and with unprecedented climate change. But first, let me remind you of our very diverse and talented region.
Our region is composed of 11 management entities over three continents and 59 affiliates in Europe, except in France and Ireland, Latin America, Africa, and the Middle East, travel retail excluded. With its 5,721 employees, it is a very diverse and inclusive region where 81 nationalities collaborate and work together to deliver 30% of Group Pernod Ricard sales. Last but not least, we have a highly committed team. The latest employee survey released at the beginning of November this year showed a very positive engagement rate of 81%, in line with last year and 6 points above benchmark.
Pernod Ricard's purpose unlocks the magic of human connections and business model were, are, and will be our strongest asset to grow. Now, let's come back to last year's performance of EMEA LATAM as a perfect illustration of our group's strong and broad-based growth. Let's watch a short video.
We have beaten symbolic milestones for the first time, respectively 3 billion and 1 billion of sales and operating profit. We did it through premiumization with record price mix of 13%. As compared to pre-COVID period, our last 3-year growth rate has been multiplied by 2, from 5% to 10%.
This diversified growth came from all geographical areas and all our business battlegrounds.
We did it by gaining share, beating competition in more than 90% of the markets. We achieved that despite COVID, despite supply disruption, and despite the consequences of the conflict in Ukraine. At the same time, we made very good progress against our longer-term priorities: deployment of digital transformation towards conviviality platform, strong progress on gender diversity on our way to balanced organization in 2030.
So yes, our strategy is working and delivering very good results in fiscal year 22. Let's look at them in more detail. Our transversal business battlegrounds have been key value growth drivers. First, win the whiskey battle, plus 31% net sales growth. Our whiskey portfolio performed very strongly across the region, notably in our emerging geographies, Sub-Saharan Africa, Brazil, Central America, Andina, and Turkey. For Chivas, it has been an important year with the introduction of a new pack and a new campaign, I Rise, We Rise, to continue driving engagements with a new generation of whiskey drinkers. Jameson continues its strong momentum, growing brand awareness and with strong acceleration in South Africa and Nigeria. Second, reinvigorate vodka, plus 36% net sales growth. Absolut, plus 39%, enjoyed a strong continued growth across all areas, benefiting from on-trade, nightlife, and tourism recovery. Third, accelerate on gin, plus 47% net sales growth. Our gin portfolio is going from strength to strength. Beefeater is expanding beyond its traditional markets, experiencing strong growth in Brazil, Mexico, South Africa. In super premium and upper premium segments, Malfy had an exceptional year in its home market, Italy. The activation team in Italy has done a tremendous job to drive awareness and gain distribution, leading to volumes multiplied by close to 7 times. Let's watch a video to illustrate the success of Malfy.
Hey!
In the upper premium segment, Monkey 47 continues its success story with double-digit growth, expanding across the region with Germany, UK, and Italy as strongholds. Fourth, seize the aperitif moment, in particular with Lillet growing 7%. Lillet continues to grow in Western Europe, but also in Brazil and Italy. Our key brands initiatives continue building the aspiration of the brand with focus on female consumers. Accelerates on Prestige, plus 36%. Prestige continues to be a focus area of acceleration in our region, and we posted strong results. Last year was driven by the Prestige Scotch with Chivas 18, plus 48%, and Royal Salute 21, plus 88%. Champagne, plus 51%, driven by Perrier Jouet Belle Époque and Moom Grand Cordon. And Cognac with Martel Blue Swift, plus 95% in Nigeria. Six, increase share of innovation. 49% growth with an incremental growth of 3%. Innovation continues to be a key acceleration space as we continue to adapt quickly to the new moments of consumption. We have three focus areas in order to fuel a sustained and diversified growth profile for innovation. Line extensions, as consumers are willing to explore new expressions of our core brands, like Beefeater Flavors, Ballantine Sevens, and Chivas XV. A greater focus on stretch innovation, tapping into emerging consumer trends with the launch, for example, in Spain of Beefeater and Ballantine's Light as pioneers of the moderation space and great response from trade and consumers. Finally, we continue enriching our portfolio. Here, following the success story of Monkey 47, Malfy is a great example of how we continue building new growth relays. Seventh, fiscal year 22 was also a year of acceleration for our sustainability and responsibility roadmap. I would like to specifically highlight our achievements in two pillars of our SNR roadmap. First, the people pillar, with two major items. Our diversity and inclusion agenda is getting stronger as we keep improving the work initiated a few years ago on gender. Over the last 4 years, for top management, we moved from 19% of women in 2018 to 34% in 2022, plus 15 points, getting closer to our 2030 objective of 40 to 60% of women. Additionally, we are proud partner of not only UN Women in Latin America, but also Women International Networking. Let me also say a few words on our initiative, Bar World of Tomorrow, a global sustainability training program developed in partnership with Anti-Waste Bartending, Duo Trash Collective, and the Sustainable Restaurant Association in the UK. Our region has activated and promoted this initiative in every single market. Let's watch a short clip to illustrate the progress made in this area. Second, let me briefly reflect on our responsible hosting pillar, which is a must for our industry, and to which we commit very seriously to promote responsible consumption. Last year, I presented to you our Drink More Water campaign, targeting young adults, the Gen Z, and fighting binge drinking. Let's watch a short clip about this fantastic campaign and its results.
Drink more water. Since its launch in July 2021, the campaign successfully reached more than 181 million young adults across 35 EMEA LATAM markets, generating 1.3 million clicks. In just 19 markets, we surpassed 231 million impressions. With the return of in-person events, it also marked the transition from digital to physical for the campaign. Drink More Water was present and activated in many Erasmus parties, festival, and on-trade events around the region, reaching more than 681,000 young adults in 26 markets. One last figure to conclude. 1,151,173. That's the number of young adults Responsible Party has managed to reach on the field since the start of the program in 2009, with the strong contribution of the Drink More Water campaign. Cheers to drinking more water.
Let's now take a closer look at our main initiatives and results by geographical area. In fiscal year 22, growth was broad-based. All our management entities growing. Western Europe, driven by on-trade rebounds. Eastern and Central Europe, despite the consequences of the conflict in Ukraine. Turkey and Sub-Saharan Africa being the most dynamic area. And LATAM region, driven by tourism, on-trade and events, and also positive mix. Before deep diving into those four areas, let's watch a summary of our main initiatives in the markets this year. Starting with our more mature Western European markets. The UK and Germany, who had very strong double-digit growth in fiscal year 21, were able to continue growing in fiscal year 22, benefiting from continued momentum in both channels, on and off. Spain plus 36% and Italy plus 42%, meanwhile, were boosted by the on-trade rebound in fiscal year 22, especially thanks to lower restrictions. In Italy, Malfi is contributing very significantly, multiplying its sales by almost four. Growth was solid in Northern Europe against strong comparison basis and thanks to delayed travel normalization. Central Europe kept growing very dynamically across the management entity thanks to the continued growth of whiskey. Despite the significant drop since February, Eastern Europe still posted solid growth in fiscal year 22. Thanks to the very strong starts driven by sellouts before Ukraine conflicts and to ongoing dynamism of markets such as Kazakhstan. Turkey grew very strong double digits in both volume and value, supported by continued growing trend in spirit markets. We gained share in the traditional off-trade market. We also improved coverage and in-store execution, and we showed high pricing power. Turkey is now the largest market for Chivas Regal in the world. The emerging markets in the region had an extraordinary year, significantly scaling up thanks to the strength of the portfolio, targeted investments, and talented organization. It allowed us to continue building our positions, leveraging dynamic demographic trends and the emergence of middle classes. LATAM and Sub-Saharan Africa are accelerating versus last year and beginning to reach a scale that is delivering strong profitability, more than doubling the amounts they were reporting in fiscal year 21. LATAM's very dynamic growth was driven by Scotch brands, Chivas, Ballantine's, by Absolut, and by the fast-growing Beefeater gin. Mexico grew strong double digits thanks to off-trade dynamism, as well as strong on-trade and tourism recovery. Andina benefited from the successful results of strong portfolio strategy and route-to-market transformation. Brazil growth plus 52% is boosted by global brands dynamism and strong mix, together with effective multi-channel approach to seize benefits of the new consumer trends. Sub-Saharan Africa showed a strong double-digit growth driven by the great performance of Jameson that reached the fantastic milestone of 1 million cases in the whole region, and also by Martell, notably in Nigeria. So overall, excellent dynamism and business performance translating into market share gains in almost all our markets, notably in Turkey, South Africa, Poland, and Brazil. Comparing to pre-COVID, our business has made significant gains, with the on-trade now at a few points ahead of fiscal year 19 on average, and the off-trade an astounding 20 points ahead, with both channels continuing to grow. In terms of post-COVID rebound, we believe it is now complete everywhere, with the possible exception of Spain and Italy, where there could be some additional on-trade gains in fiscal year 23. So, what should we expect for fiscal year 23? The region has posted a strong start to the year, with Q1 sales at plus 9%. The very positive consumer trends observed in fiscal year 22 are continuing to drive our business in terms of geography. Spain, double-digit growth, notably driven by our gin portfolio, Absolut and whiskey. On-trade rebounding with strong tourism, while off-trade remains resilient. Germany, very strong growth, notably driven by Lillet and Ramazzotti. UK, soft starts due to wine decline in off-trade and high comparison basis with staycation in fiscal year 22. Eastern Europe, sharp decline, fully driven by the conflict in Ukraine. Good start in Central Europe on a high basis, especially in very dynamic Romania and Hungary. Brazil continued double-digit growth enhanced by good pricing and strong mix. Mexico, strong start with Absolut and Chivas Regal. Q1 growth is also boosted by our record double-digit price effect, thanks to the increases taken in H2 fiscal year 22 and the new increases made in Q1. Pricing has always been a key focus for Pernod Ricard, and even more so in the current inflationary context. Pre-COVID average pricing was 2%. We started accelerating last year, starting in H1, notably in emerging markets, and moving to mature markets in H2. We will continue increasing prices on this high comparison basis, as Q1 already demonstrates. In an environment that remains uncertain, we need to leverage our strong momentum, focus on value, and keep transforming our business. We have 5 hot topics and priorities for fiscal year 23. Number 1, grow top line, protect margins, and maximize pricing in the context of unprecedentedly high inflation, activating all possible levers. Number 2, agile resource allocation in a volatile environment. Number 3, continue transformation to make Pernod Ricard a conviviality platform with the deployment of our digital programs in more countries. Number 4, accelerate on sustainability and responsibility. Number 5, create the best possible environment for our people, in particular in terms of well-being, diversity and inclusion, and careers opportunities. I am confident because we have a strong momentum, we have the right strategy, we have the best portfolio, and we have the best people. To summarize last year EMEA LATAM performance in one word, remarkable. The region has delivered very strong growth, twice as much in the last 3 years as compared to the previous 3 years, at both top and bottom line levels, thanks to the engagement of our teams, our clear strategy, and the strengths of our brands. Our priorities for fiscal year 23 are clear and should enable to continue delivering above market growth while protecting our margins. But more than ever, I'd like to keep my final words for, first, our EMEA LATAM teams for their incredible commitments and performance over the last year, and for their resilience in the current challenging context. And naturally, for our purpose, créateur de convivialité, and our mission, unlocking the magic of human connections. The world needs it more than ever.